We're going to use science to do a bit of time traveling.
Join us as we open the aging chambers at the Library of Congress.
So this is the Accelerated Aging Lab in the Preservation Research and Testing Division. We use these chambers with heat, light, and humidity to study how materials age over time.
So these machines accelerate what might happen to an item as it sits on a shelf or in a museum?
That's exactly right. We're going to do some experiments looking at new repair adhesives that have never been used before to see what they might look like and how they might behave over time so that conservators feel comfortable using them on their collection items.
So that machine's going to help us answer that.
It's going to apply some heat and humidity, and we're going to see what these two adhesives might look like, what might happen to them in hundreds of years from now.
Wow, now I see a difference.
These are matching samples, which were prepared at the same time. They've been in the oven experiencing elevated heat and humidity for about a month now. And so that accelerates the chemistry that would happen in an office setting by about 100 years. So which of these looks better to you?
I think I'd rather use this one.
I think that one looks better to me too. This one looks a lot darker and more brittle. So we can take these back to the lab now and do some careful measurements to see how their color or their strength changed. And those results could inform the users and the conservators on which adhesive they'd prefer to use when making their repairs on collection items. We've been talking about paper and adhesives, but we use this equipment to study any of the types of collection materials that the library has. That includes things like audiovisual materials, like audio tapes. We've used them on CDs. We've used them on fabrics and inks and pigments.
You can even do your own experiments at home to test how light affects the aging process of materials. Using a newspaper or any kind of old paper, you can put it in the sun, fold it up, and then see how areas that were more exposed to light look differently over time versus those that were covered.
And you can also modify that experiment however you like. You could take different films or foil or other coverings and cover different parts of the paper and see how it protects or doesn't protect that paper from light exposure.
It's really impressive that the experiments you do here help the library preserve precious items that have been around for hundreds of years.
The experiments may seem simple, and it's incredible to me too that their results from just samples like this can be applied to centuries-old priceless objects that we're working to preserve for ages to come.